First of all, Jim Babbitt. And Jim Babbitt, which was Jim's table. Oh, there he is. Jim Babbitt has not only run the downtown business for many decades, but he has dedicated himself in every way possible to help maintain Flagstaff's special quality of life. Born and raised in Flagstaff, Jim has a deep, deep passion for our community's historic past and exciting future. So, very quickly, let's say hi to Jim. Next tonight, we have Senator Kate Brophy McGee. Senator, which table are you? I'm very proud. And serving in her first term in the Arizona Senate, after serving 6 years in the Arizona House, Senator Brophy McGee is a member of both the Senate Education and the Transportation Technology Committees. Senator Brophy McGee is a third generation Arizona, born into a ranching family and raised in Southern Arizona. So let's give a quick applause to her. Tonight we also have Eileen Klein, and Eileen is in the back. Welcome. And Eileen, with more than 20 years of strategic fiscal and executive management experience in both the public and the private sector, Eileen serves as president of the Arizona Board of Regents, which her role is to support Arizona's public universities in achieving critical goals to serve students and transform Arizona's economy. The Arizona Board of Regents oversees a $5.2 billion enterprise serving 179,000 students in Arizona. So let's say hi to you. Next we have Dr. Rita Chang. President Chang serves as the 16th president of Northern Arizona University, and President Chang is right here in Middleton. Under her leadership, NAU is engaged in a strategic planning effort to position the university to thrive in the fast-changing environment of higher education. President Chang's focus is to expand on the university's historic strengths, providing access to an affordable quality education for all students, and pursuing discovery, advancement, and application of knowledge in research areas unique and important to our region. So let's say hi to President Chang. And of course, our final table is with Mayor Coral Evans, and Mayor Coral is serving her first year as mayor, as Flagstaff's mayor, having been elected in November 2016. Although not new to the position of mayor, Ms. Evans has served on the council for two terms, I believe, and so we really want to welcome her to the best tonight. So let's have So again, we're going to start our conversation much like you would around the dinner table. You know, we're all around the table tonight, and I was lucky enough in which when we sat down at the dinner table, we talked about everything with my parents, and we typically got our marching orders for the day, but it provided an opportunity for all of us to come together and just have a conversation about a lot of things that were important to us as a community. And so that's what we're here tonight. So at this point, I'm going to invite Jim Babbitt to start our comments. Jim?
Thank you very much, Steve. I don't find my name.
Next time.
Okay. I would just like to say thanks to all my fellow panelists. John is waiting me to stand up. Okay. Thanks to all my fellow panelists, and thank you, Steve, for moderating with us tonight. But I guess most of all, I would like to say thanks to all of you for coming out to begin this important conversation tonight. Now, I have written down my remarks. My poor little brain would never be able to remember all that I wanted to say tonight without writing it down. So I'm going to start out with a quote my cousin Billy Cordesco is very fond of using from Abraham Lincoln. And Lincoln said, "If we could first know where we are and whither we are tending, we would better know what to do and how to do it." And that has really served our business as well, that advice through the years. That's been a good guidepost. But a lot of you might know that I'm kind of stuck about 100 years in the past, and I really like history a lot. So I have paraphrased that quote, and I'm going to come back to the first quote in a little bit, but my paraphrase goes like this. If we could just know where we have been and where we are, we would better know where we're going and how to get there. So that's the beginning of my remarks. Anybody from Illinois who might be familiar with Abraham Lincoln might recognize some of those quotes. Anyway, Flagstaff is a young city established in 1882, only 135 years old. That was older than I am by a little bit, but not by much. We're a new town. My family arrived in 1886, a year after the city was founded. My family, the city, and NAU have all grown up and developed together. My granduncle, David Babbitt, was Flagstaff's second mayor in 1894. Many other family members have served through the years in elected and appointed positions with the city, including as mayors and city councilmen. Platt Klein, in his Mountain Town book, writes that the people who came to Flagstaff in the 1880s were not boomers or speculators, but rather people determined to build a community with steady jobs, good schools, and churches. My family has built buildings and developed property and has been a part of the commercial fabric of Flagstaff for well over a century. We also grew up with NAU. My grandparents lobbied the territorial legislature to establish the Northern Arizona Normal School, now NAU. My granduncle literally helped build NAU in the early days, as reflected in his 1918 clipping from the Coconino site. Quote, all of the construction work on the addition to the main building of the Northern Arizona Normal School has been placed in the charge of George Babbitt. That's 1918. Several buildings on campus have our family name, and cousins and uncles have served on the Board of Regents. We also have supported the university through the years with scholarship programs and funding for KNAU. So, Flagstaff citizens have grown up with and alongside the city, its government, and Northern Arizona University. We are all in this together. Coming back to Lincoln's first quote, many citizens are not really sure where they now, that they know where Flagstaff is presently. And they are worried whether the city is tending, seeing massive student housing projects springing up along with big new residential and commercial developments. Many feel bewildered, voiceless, and helpless in the face of rapid change. Worry about the ripple effects of this fast-paced change on traffic congestion, parking, affordable housing, historic neighborhoods, and the unique character of Flagstaff. One of Flagstaff's most precious assets is our historic buildings and neighborhoods. These assets help define our unique character, but are now vulnerable to being raised to accommodate new development. In Tucson, nearly six square blocks of historic homes were recently torn down for a hub-like student housing project. As a longtime advisor to the National Trust for Historic Preservation, I advocate for preserving historic structures and neighborhoods. They are what make our city unique. Flagstaff's population when I was born, which was a very long time ago, was 7,000 people. It is now estimated at almost 72,000 people, with 26,000 new residents in the last 20 years alone. It seems unlikely that this rate of growth can be sustained going forward. Former City Council member Dr. Murray Feldstein, I'm sure a lot of people in the room remember Dr. Feldstein, observed in his profession that steady, moderate cell growth is normal. Extremely rapid cell growth is called cancer. So in closing, it is my hope that tonight's conversation will be the first step in coming together to devise strategies for more sustainable growth and for increasing communication and cooperation between and among our citizens, our city government,